Hi guys, what's up? I had some requests regarding to how to model a scene using fSpy. Okay, so we are going to model this scene using fSpy. So for those who don't know fSpy, I will leave the website on the comment down below so you can download it. So firstly, you have to download it for your PC or Mac, and then you have to download the add-on for Blender, okay? Also, the website has a pretty good tutorial on how to use it. So I'm not going deeply on how to use it, but I will show you my technique and how I use it to create my scenes, okay? So let's open up fSpy. You type here fSpy. Okay, so this is the basic interface. It's pretty simple, actually. Let's import the image. So import this image, the image we're going to work with. This one. And firstly, we have here the number of vanishing points. Okay, so it's set by default by 2. But we are going to use actually one vanishing point. Okay, so as you can see, when I change to one vanishing point, we only have three arrows. Okay, and these blue arrows means the Z axis and the red one, the X axis. If I change to two vanishing points, we are going to have two Z axis. Okay, so it's a little bit more complicated, and in most of the cases I use one vanishing point, okay? Okay, so another thing that this software does is it collects the information from the camera. Okay, so that's why you have a lot of things going on here. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is create our first vanishing point. Okay, so I will drag and drop these arrows to align it to the corresponding x-axis. Okay, so we are moving the x-axis. So we have like two arrows. So one I use on the left, and this one I use it on the right. Okay, so as you can see, the way I'm moving it, I'm starting to have this vanishing point. And it's very important we create this vanishing point, otherwise you can't work very well with fSpy on Blender, okay? So let's adjust, let's align the Z axis. Okay, so I place the Z axis on this part because this part is more close to the camera and it's easier to place it, okay? So as you can see, we have created this vanishing point based on this down part of the image. But we can create this vanishing point on the upper part of this image. As you can see, I'm using now these arrows, this x-axis on the upper part. So we still have the same vanishing point, okay? So I will change it. For me, I think it's better use this part because I have a longer vanity working in this image. So I believe it will work more accurate if I work here down below. Okay, so I will keep these vanishing points. So as you can see, we have this pivot over here. And this pivot helps us to understand the 3D, the dimensions, and the 3D space of this image. So as you can see, my Z axis is inverted. So I have just to change it to Z because it was like negative Z, and then the Z is up. Also, you can create a box and see more properly, actually, how a cube or how any object will be in this image when we start creating it on Blender. Okay, So this is a pretty good tool that can help us before jump to Blender. Okay, so let's save it and open it in Blender. Okay, so just save it as any name you want, and let's jump to Blender and open it up. Okay, so let's wait a little bit to Blender start. Yep. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is import this fSpy. Okay, so go to import, and if you install it correctly, you're going to have this fSpy import. Okay, so just go to the page, to the folder, sorry, and open it up. So the kitchen one, in my case, this one. So as you can see, we have the image already set up. In my case, I have two cameras. Actually, I had a red one set up in my startup. So, okay. The first thing I'm going to do is create a box. And one thing that's very important to mention right now is that it's quite impossible we have the dimensions of the scene. So we have to guess. The only way that you can have the dimensions is if the room you took the photo was your room, or for some reason you know the space and you know the dimensions, okay? Otherwise, if you like, if you got any image from the internet, you probably won't have the dimensions, okay? So we have to guess. So I will place the cube in front of my camera. As you can see, it's already working very well. It looks like the cube is in the image. So first thing I'm going to do is I will place the pivot on the bottom, and then I will reset the z-axis and increase the dimensions of the z-axis. We have this cube has actually 2 meters, so I believe this room has 2 meters and I don't know, 2 meters and a half to 2.6 meters, something like that, based on the door. Maybe the door is 2.2. So let's work with 2.6 meters, okay? So as you can, as I said, it's quite impossible we predicted the dimensions. So we have to adjust the camera based on the dimensions we set, okay? So the first thing we have to pay attention is the lines of the cube, okay? And these lines need to be aligned to the architecture. So in this example, we have the walls, the ceiling, and the floor. So we have to place it to be almost in the same position as we have these walls and the ceilings and the floor, okay? So this is the work we're going to do right now. So you can always use your camera to place the cube, because if you do the opposite, if you try to place the cube, you are going to change the dimensions of the cube. So we already set 2.6 meters to the height of these walls. So it's important we keep these proportions, okay? So I'll increase a little bit the y-axis. So we can have a larger room. So I'll just place the box, actually the camera, in the middle of this box, and I increase to 2.3 meters, something like that. Maybe it's almost enough. Sorry, my WhatsApp is on. I will turn it off. Okay. So let's continue here. I increase the x-axis as well. And now we are moving the box, but just backward to cover the camera and keep the same lines aligned with the walls and ceiling and floor. Okay. Let me decrease a little bit, maybe 2.2 in the y-axis. I think it's almost there, almost center. I think this is the most annoying part of this this tutorial, because we have to try to be precise when doing it. Okay. But I think you guys got the point, right? Yeah, I think it's good. It's good enough. Let's see the scale. Let's place my little guy inside the room. Yeah, it's not bad. The scale looks good, looks right. So it's important. Keep the scale right. Okay. So I think the next thing we're going to do right now is create the rows for the door and the window. Okay. So I'll change it to edit mode and I start cutting it off. Okay. So let's start adding some edge loops. So two edge loops here. Another one on the horizontal. Having this horizontal line edge loop, actually, we already have it for the window as well. So let's place another one, something like here. Another one, oops, maybe let me push it up a little bit. Okay, yeah, something like this. Another one for the window. Somewhere like here. And another one maybe here. Yeah, pretty good. So now it's time to delete this face. So I will select this face and delete, and this two face here and delete it. So yeah, now the door is open and the window is open. So I will apply this solidify to create a thickness to my walls. Maybe I will apply the all transform first. Yeah, always good. So yeah, now apply the solidify, increase the thickness, and let me see. Yeah, not bad. Okay, from now on, guys, I will speed up this video. And what I'm going to do is create the entire room, because as you can see, it's just modeling. So you have to model everything. I don't have, actually, I didn't model everything here. I had some props that I got from 3D Sky. I had some from my library. So I would just start placing things and modeling some parts of the objects that I don't have. And yeah. So I think now it's like the fun part, actually. So I really encourage you guys to try to do this. Maybe this, I will leave the link from this reference down below, so you can try to replicate the same things. Okay, so also I will leave the link of the props I got from 3D Sky. So you can use it as well. Actually, I paid it. Probably I got some for free, but other ones I read like had it or like I paid it. But You can always use your props, don't need to be exactly the same. Actually, as you can see, like, I'm not using the exactly same object that has in this image. You can put some different ones and maybe try different style. It's, I know that's nice to try to replicate like real photos, but it's awesome to try to create something new, so based on the inspirational. So looks like we are almost done here. Let me see. Yeah, this is the final result. So pretty similar, as you can see, and this can be applied to any kind of image. Okay, so I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and see you in the next one.